Hey there, it's Lynda Cromar coming to you from Colorado, and as you can see, I'm in my car. That's because I'm waiting on my son. I'm helping him get his groceries. And my title today, talking about there is no right way to take the action. There is no perfect words to say to any individual. I know that you hear a lot of people say you can't say the wrong thing to the right person, or the right thing to the wrong person. That's just not true. You can say the wrong things to the right person. The hard part is you're never going to know what those words are, and you're never going to know what that action is if you don't do a little trial and error. And I know that's hard, but people want a perfect formula, a perfect set of words. And I even had people ask, do you use NLP? No. You know why? Because people know when they're being manipulated, and that never works, really. You've got to get out of the mindset. You think you have to say specific things in a specific way. Yes, you can say it wrong, but yes, you can say it wrong because you're trying to use things that don't really make sense. It's kind of like, do you become professor in front of your friends when you start talking about your product and service? I know my son used to do that all the time, drove me crazy. I said, that doesn't turn me on. That isn't what gets me. What gets people, to tell you the truth, is not how much knowledge you have, but how much emotion you have. Because if the belief comes through your eyes, even if the words aren't perfect, it's going to have a bigger effect, because heart to heart communicates much better than having the right words. I promise you that's the truth. Heart to heart, when you start thinking about that person as a real person that you care about and you want to help, not that you think you have to manipulate them into it, or you have to convince them in some way. It never works that way, I promise you. I've been through this enough. I've been in this industry for over 20 years, and I know it doesn't work to be a convincer, a commercial, like I talked about earlier in one of my other videos. Don't try to be the commercial. Don't try to be the convincer. Start talking heart to heart. What do you feel? What do you know because of your own experience? When it comes from that kind of feeling, people are more likely to actually listen. They don't even know why they're listening. And if they join, they usually don't even know why they join. I asked somebody one time when they joined me, because I had this spurt when I did a 90-day run and a whole bunch of people joined me all at once. And I asked this one lady, what is it that made you join me? And she said, I felt your heart. I want you to think about that for a minute. I felt your heart. I felt your belief. I really resonated with that. They don't even have to say those kind of words. When you know how to really convey who you are and why you're where you are. So it's more about a story. It's more about a belief. It's more about who you are. And your words are not going to be my words. And my words are not going to be your words. It just doesn't work that way. It has to be real. It has to be sincere. And you have to tell stories. When you get good at that, you're going to have the results you want. That's why I always use a list building system instead of trying to convince them to get in. They're not ready when they just barely get acquainted with you. They want to start learning who you are. And when you start sharing who you are on a regular basis like I do, people start coming to you and say, I feel you. What are you really doing? What is it that's got you so excited? What is it that you share? Then you have the opportunity to share it the right way. There's no special words. There's no special action, except for consistent action. Sharing your story, being willing to give them your real self. Stop trying to be the manipulator. Stop trying to be the convincer. And start being real and start being you. And when you do that, people will join you. That's what I have to share with you today as I'm waiting for my son to come out with his groceries. And I hope you have a most awesome weekend, and happy Easter to all that believe in that. And we'll be talking again soon. Bye for now.